guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be doing a book review over the 5 a.m. Club. So if you want to hear my thoughts and opinions, go ahead and keep watching. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to all of those who are new. If you would, hit that subscribe button, like this video, and make sure to leave a comment down below on what you thought of this video. The engagement really helps us YouTubers and I would really appreciate it. Now, I have read The 5 a.m. Club and I absolutely loved it. So, a little backstory. I found Robin Sharma, who's the author of this book. I found him when I was in high school. So I was like browsing YouTube or something and I came across his videos and one of them was about The 5 a.m. Club. And I started implementing the 5 a.m. Club for like 2 days. And then I ended up being like, no, I don't want to do this. I want to wait because I think that this would be more beneficial to me when I'm out of school, when I'm like an adult. And also I want to read his book because I didn't think that what he put in the like 5-minute video was all that he had to say about the 5 a.m. Club and the method. And I was right, it wasn't. And I really just wanted to have the book and study the book instead of having to go back to the video. I just wanted something I could hold. So I went ahead and didn't do the 5 a.m. Club. And then I kept up with him though. I kept up with the publishing process of this book. And it took him like 4 years to actually write. So one day, this book was released. And almost like on the launch day, I went to Barnes & Noble and they didn't have it. And so I went ahead and I ordered it online and I bought it. And I started reading it. And I can actually tell that when I started reading it, I can just tell what mindset I was in. But I started reading it about a year ago and I got about 100 pages in before I just stopped. I wasn't in the right mindset to absorb this book and to put those practices into place and to really just appreciate this method. I just wasn't in the right mindset. I was incredibly depressed. I was going through a breakup and I really wasn't in the right mindset. And so about a year later, after that, I have had trouble sleeping. And there was one night where I was miserable. I was in a lot of pain and I looked at the clock. I had gotten up and taken more pain medicine and due to something that had happened. And I looked at the clock and it was 5 a.m. And I was like, honestly, I have woken up every single hour. I am not getting any sleep. It's 5 a.m. Like, I'm giving up on the sleep. And I kind of looked over to my bookshelf and I thought, this would actually be a really good time to read the 5 a.m. Club. And hey, it's 5 a.m. right now. So I went ahead and I grabbed the 5 a.m. Club and I began reading it. And almost immediately I fell in love with this book. And I actually have started implementing the methods that he talks about in his book. And I need to reread this book. It's been about a week since I've read it. No, it's been about two. And I love this book. I think Robin did a phenomenal job. You can really tell how much heart and soul he put into this, especially because he took 4 years to write this book. He really did. And then I also annotated certain passages that I wanted to go back to. Like, there are a couple quotes. Like, one of my favorites is, "All change is hard at first, messy in the middle, and gorgeous at the end." And let's see. "She found that what makes the most successful achievers so great isn't their inherent talent, but their levels of commitment, discipline, resilience, and perseverance." So it's very much like a self-help book, a motivational book, and I love this. I read last year the Rachel Hollis book and I really liked it, but when I went into this book I actually thought thought it would be more like the Rachel Hollis book. It would be Robin sitting down and writing his kind of experiences, his thoughts, his opinions, like that. I thought it was going to be like the 5 a.m. Club video. But it wasn't. It was actually told like a novel, and it took me a little bit to get used to it. I actually didn't want to read it. I actually wanted to chuck it in the trash because I just didn't like it. It was, and I had a mindset of, you know, negativity when I began reading this a year ago, and I was like, this isn't what I wanted, so I'm gonna throw it away. But I kind of knew like there was something in this that I needed to kind of allow myself to enjoy. And so a year later, I kind of got past the writing style. I actually really enjoyed it. I thought I actually am really impressed that he did it so well. I don't think I could have done it this well, but basically he creates this tale about the billionaire, the entrepreneur, and I don't know who it is. I don't know who the third one is. I forgot. I need to reread it. But basically, it kind of just goes through. It's in third person, and they meet this billionaire, and he's not what he seems. And so he whisks them away to this island that he has, and eventually they kind of just go through the 5 a.m. Club. They go through every lesson over a couple of weeks, and that's how the book's kind of drawn out. I thought it was masterful. I thought it was very insightful, and I really liked how you saw the characters put their stuff, the lessons, into their everyday lives and saw how they did that and saw the results of that. So I really appreciated that. I love Robin Sharma. I love his works, his writings, but I could not get over the romance in this book. I thought it was not necessary. I thought it was cringy. I did not appreciate it. I just didn't. I mean, Robin Sharma is not like a fiction. I hate like bashing him. He's not like a fiction author. He's a self-help coach, and he's phenomenal at that. But writing romance was not his thing, and maybe he didn't want the readers to connect with it. I don't know. I didn't see, like, I usually, when I see a book, like, I can see the chemistry between two characters, and that's, he missed that. All of a sudden they were in a relationship, and I was like, what? All of a sudden they were engaged. It's been 2 days. Didn't you guys just get together? The time lapsing in this book's a little bit confusing, but all in all, I read this for the self-help and the self-motivation, and just with that, it's a 5 out of 5 stars. I love the 5 a.m. Club. I actually wake up now at 5 a.m. every morning. I take Saturday, Sunday off, but typically I wake up at 5 a.m. now, and I actually have really been enjoying it. I get more work done. I am much more productive, and I'm just happier. I realized that, like, the days I don't do the 5 a.m. Club, I still wake up at 5 a.m. and my body's like, let's go. Let's go. You know, it's time to start the day. So with all that being said, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below what kind of content you want to see next. And if you haven't already picked up the 5 a.m. Club, do yourself a favor and do it. It's one of the best books I've ever read. I love Robin Sharma. I cannot wait for his next book. He's actually working on it right now. And I can't talk enough praise about this book. So hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in my next one.